call me Frank. It's much easier to say.
Okay, Frank. Let's get down to business. So, Frank, where were you born?
Australia.
Any part of Australia or just Australia?
Sydney, Australia.
Wow, that's really interesting. You don't see that a lot, no? You don't see a lot of Australia these days, no?
Yeah, especially
in America. So, Mr. Frank, what exactly inspired you to become a writer?
Well, at first, I actually wanted to become like a house painter like my father. But you know, after knocking down a couple of paint cans and painting myself into corners, you know, I realized it wasn't really that for me. So I read a couple books, and I was inspired to become a writer.
Oh, good stuff, good stuff. And what books inspired you?
One was called The Old Man and the Sea. And what was the other one? The other was What's Eating Gilbert Grape? It's a weird name, I know. But after reading these books, I started writing. But you know, after a few years of being rejected, I almost lost hope, but I never gave up. I always pushed myself. Yeah, basically.
You seem like a cool guy, Frank. So, how many years?
How many years I got rejected? I got rejected for 7 years, but, you know, finally when it got published, it really paid off.
Well, rejection hurts, man. I'm pretty impressed, you know, for how you just snapped right back up, you know? You don't see that much, you know? People usually, when they get rejected, they give up.
Yeah, they're true. They just give up. They're not. Mm-hmm. I always say, push yourself, push yourself.
Good stuff.
Man.
That's fascinating. So you have written many books, but what inspired you to write the book, Theif? I mean, did you, like, steal some books yourself, or?
That's fine. No, what really inspired me to write this book is, as a child, growing up, man, like, my mother told me stories about the bombing in Munich, how people described it as the sky being on fire, and, like, the devastation of it all. Also, another story that my mother told me was a story about a little boy who gave a Jewish person bread, and a Nazi officer saw this, so not only did he beat the Jewish person for accepting the bread, he beat the Jewish boy. And this is like the side of Germany everyone sees, but I also wanted to write about the side of Germany that people don't see, the side where people hid Jews in like their basements and like tunnels in the house. Also, like people who like really didn't like the Nazi Party, that they just like didn't believe in the ideals that they had.
Interesting. Nice. So we're kind of getting off topic here, but you know, who are you as a person? Who are you truly? Like, what do people do not see, or, you know, what's normal about you? Because I know you're a big-time writer, you know, that's very big.
Well, I'm married. I have a daughter. You know, people have favorite numbers. Mine is 13. I like to surf mainly, because play soccer as well. I am the youngest of four children from German and Australian parents who were actually immigrants to Australia. And their hardships of their past really also inspired me in writing as well.
It's pretty interesting. Well, your parents, you know, you never know, you could have been in the same hardships if, you know, they hadn't, you know, tried as hard, you know. As people, we forget, you know, how hard our parents try and stuff, and we forget how every day, you know, they come and, yeah, they see us and, you know, working hard and stuff, they're children, and they expect the best of us, but, you know, they never give up on us. any parent's story would inspire anyone, but I mean your parents, I mean you suffered a lot. You know? Pretty nice knowing that they created a great person. Well, it's nice that you're active. If you could meet anyone that ever lived, who would it be? I know this is another random topic, but I mean
that's alright, you know. Good that people know the real me, not just a rich person. But I have actually thought about this question for a while. I would actually meet Michelangelo. How about you?
And why Michelangelo?
You know, because his artistic things, like his work, his artistic work inspired me. You know?
Yeah, I get you. Michelangelo, Leonardo da Vinci, you know, they were big time guys, you know,
yeah,
back in the day.
That's why they created these turtles.
It's pretty cool. You watching the turtles too? You see turtles in
Australia?
Yeah,
I watch TV as well. You know, I watch some TV. I watch movies with my daughters. I watch TV a lot.
That's cool. You know, everyone has to have some TV.
Yes.
Well, you asked me, well, who would I be? Who would I meet? Yeah. I never really put thought into this, and I really have to think about this because there's so many amazing people out in the world. I really don't know, you know, who. And even those who made like the simplest thing, like a fork or something, would be kind of, you know, a good person to meet. Because I like, what gave you the idea to come up with the idea, you know? What gave you the idea? And
yeah, inspiration.
Yeah, but I think the one person that I would like to meet is Joan of Arc.
Joan of Arc?
Yeah.
That
led the army to defeat England.
Yeah,
cool. I like that girl. And she was young. She was only about like 15, 16. Now then, she's crazy. Well, I believe we all kind of talk to voices sometimes, you know. We're not always normal. I know I talk to myself all the time. You know, there's even some weirdos that talk to a camera and the computer. But yeah, anyway. So another question to get off topic. I know it's a little weird. I get off topic a lot.
I see that.
You know, we're not even talking about animals, but what kind of animals do you have?
It's funny, really. Yeah, this is funny because I'm a dog person. Like, but it's funny because I actually started having cats. I had two cats before I actually had my own dog. I have no idea why. I'm not really sure why. It's weird, you know. I'm a dog person, but I have a cat. But then I'm like, man, I don't like this cat. And then I got myself a dog.
What did you do to the cat? Did you kill it or something?
No, it's still there.
I hope it's alive.
No.
Now getting back to you, Mr. Frank, what is your birthday exactly?
My birthday, you know, June 23rd, 1975.
Yep. Pretty old, I mean. So I got some years in you,
yeah.
You look young, but you know,
yeah.
You know, Father Time's coming for you, but
yeah.
Live while you can. That's all I say. Whoa, I see death upon you. I'm just kidding. Anyway.
Oh, you burned my foot. It's told by the respect of death.
Yeah. That, you know. Some would say, you know, the other day I was talking to this person about sleep and death, how they're kind of correlated. But yeah, anyways.
Anyway.
Getting back to the topic. This is your last question, Frank. I don't want to keep your time here. yeah, you gotta keep writing. Is there any advice you would give to future writers or future readers themselves?
Yes, I do actually. I just advise future readers, future writers, even present writers, to always believe in your work. Like believe in your writing. Always believe that your piece is gonna make it. Because without hope, as well, best you can, to the best of your ability, and basically do it the best you can.
Well, Mr. Frank, it was nice having you here. Can we get an applause from the audience? Well, from the audience out in the world, you know?
Yeah.
Well, Mr.
Frank.
Viewers, it was nice to meet you. We will now conclude this, and we're happy to have Frank here on this show today.